How's everyone doing? Zero here, and today I would like to bring you all another video in the series, who is the best in the world with each character in Smash 4. But before we get into that, I want to mention that I currently launched a very cool shirt for sale. It's about the most popular thing from my videos, the classic phrase, so a lot of people have been wondering. And the shirt is being sold for $20 plus shipping, and it goes anywhere and everywhere in the world, not just America. If you're interested into buying it, the link is on the screen and on the description below. So, as explained in the previous video, I am basing this off of results, consistency, and a bit of opinion. It is extremely difficult to rank this to perfection because some characters simply don't have as much results, or the players have similar results, making it even more complicated. Not to mention that the way I'm ranking these people is based off of results, where even some players may not have as many results as other players. For example, Anti could be the best player in the world for several characters in this list, but because he doesn't have as many results, maybe we don't have to consider him, but maybe we do, and it kind of changes the way that the dynamic of the list goes. But the way I am doing it is based on results, so it's more, I guess, unbiased and more easy to tell why I'm making my decision. So it's easier to follow. It makes more sense, I guess. So I've been researching a lot, asking players and members of my audience for certain characters so I can provide to you guys even more precise information. So of course, I hope that everything I'm saying makes sense to you and you can follow a sense of logic with it. As a disclaimer, of course, this is entirely my opinion. I'm gonna say this once again and should be taken as such and just that. This isn't official or law by any chance, and I want to make that clear. I hope this video brings up good discussion and even sparks up some competition between players. Who knows, maybe we could make this series something every season or year so it stays updated, but that's up to you guys. Let me know if you like this video by leaving a like or letting me know in the comments. With all of that said, let's get started with the second part. One of the best players from Mexico, Reggie, happens to be the strongest Game & Watch player in the world. With a solid performance at EVO and solid placements all around, he's without a doubt the Game & Watch with the best results, and just the best everything in general. Reggie also had some really good plays in the Genesis 3 crew battle if you want to check it out. It decently highlights recent play for him if you're curious about how good he plays. Reggie basically leads the metagame when it comes down to the big tournaments for this character because of his very, very effective play. So for me, this was a very simple pick to the side, so there you go, Reggie. Little Mac is a very obscure character in tournament. We rarely see him played nowadays, but there is one player who consistently brings him into the spotlight, and that player is Sol. And he's done a pretty good job at it, not just in singles, but also in doubles. Out of all Little Mac players, Sol simply has the most consistent and better results out of anyone. He's also been the pioneer for a lot of different Little Mac tech and setups that we see today as standard in tournament play from other Little Mac players. In a lot of ways, he's like the father of competitive Little Mac. So it's just right to position him as he deserves in this list. Man, a lot of people call this man the second Zero, even though he looks nothing like me. That kind of triggers me a lot, actually. But anyway, let's not get off topic. So I remember playing Zisser's Link even back in Brawl. This man has one hell of a long history playing with Link throughout the years. And in Smash 4, it's no different. He's actually racked up a decent amount of solid wins in the South California scene, which is a very powerful Smash scene in the first place. And among the Link players I ask, Zisser seems to be the most popular pick for best because of his overall better tournament results. It also helps that the other Link players simply go to less tournaments or just have worse results in general, so it makes it a lot easier to decide this spot. But regardless, Zisser has earned the title of best Link player in the world in my book, so props to him for that. Now, probably the first thing you'll notice is that I'm going to pronounce this man's name as Ben. Even though it's clearly a B, like B from Vector, I just literally can't pronounce it. It's like my biggest weakness in English, so I hope you can all bear with that. When asking around, the two names that were talked about the most for Best Zelda were Nairo and Ben. Nairo has impressive wins, even defeating Nintendo Sheik back in 2015 with Zelda, but Ben also has his own fair share of tournament results and wins, along with being an actual Zelda main and using her a lot more often, even in bad matchups. However, Nairo may possibly be better with Zelda. Ben has more results and a longer trajectory with the character, so it makes more sense to position Ben as the current best Zelda, so you gotta give it to him. I still think it's a bit weird to talk about myself during this type of videos, but I'm just gonna do it anyway. So I think that in terms of results, my Sheik has by far the best results. EVO, Big House, CEO, Smash Gun, Genesis, Tip Top, the list goes on. And despite there being some extremely skilled and talented Sheik players out there, I think that my record and consistency in all matchups with Sheik are a match as of now. So I think it's very fair to call myself the best Sheik player in the world. I'm just gonna let the results do the rest of the talk for me here. Ganondorf was one of the most difficult characters to rank in this list. That's because he's simply way too rare in tournaments. He's like a shiny Pokemon, I'm not even joking. This made finding the absolute best Ganondorf player very complicated. The good thing though is that from my research, Raycom was by far the most popular pick among the people I asked and the Ganondorf players. Everyone has a great amount of respect in his play and he seems to have the stronger results and wins, earning him the title best Ganondorf in the world as of now in my ranking. Toling had some difficult competition. In the US we have Zan, and in Japan we have Zigma, Hayato, and Manzuku. And every single one of these Toling players has good wins or decent results, or good results. But I personally think that one player stands out just a bit more, and that player is Hyuga. Hyuga from Mexico has recently been competing a lot in America, with a huge win on Naro and consistent high places in big America tournaments, along with extremely solid plays in his own region. Like, this man will always place well in Mexico. I think he has a very slight edge in terms of results over the other Toling players. And as I explained before, results matter a lot in this ranking. So with that said, I consider Hyuga to be the best Toling player in the world. I think that out of all Samus players, the one with the best results without a doubt is Johnny West. Now keep in mind there's no H there, but my English definitely butchered his name. So I'm sorry Johnny, damn it, I did it again. So anyway, Johnny has some really good wins in South California, the region he competes in. And SoCal is very stacked, and Johnny has managed to do well in a region with some of the best players in the country. I mean, he even took a game off of me one time. So you know he's hella good with Samus. So I think it's pretty clear who the best Samus player is. Like, come on, let's face it. Zerust Samus has amazing players behind her in general. You have Choco from Japan, Mars from New England, Nick Riddle from Florida, but there is one player that stands out with her really well, and that player is Naro. His relentless, fearless, and aggressive trademark playstyle simply flows with Zerust Samus the best. It just feels like Naro's playstyle simply brings the best from Zerust Samus. Like, it feels as if the character was meant to be played the way Naro plays her. Naro's results simply speak for themselves, having won countless tournaments in his own region, nationals in America and Japan, and defeating both Mars and Choco in the Ditto. It is without a doubt or a question that Naro is by far the best Zerust Samus player in the world. It just wouldn't make sense if he wasn't on the spot, right? I've decided to put Pit and Dark Pit as one character for the same reason I did during my tier list video, which is, if you can use one of them, you can use the other. And more often than not, Pit players play both depending on the situation. And the differences between the two characters are also very small. Earth had some good competition for this spot with Naro, but I give him the edge because he solo mains Pit, and also managed to win a big tournament in Japan over Renai with Pit, which is an impressive feat to say the least. Earth has also managed to remain impressively consistent with the same character for pretty much the whole existence of this game competitively. Throughout all patches, matchups, and just everything, he's remained solid with Pit. Sometimes he uses Dark Pit in certain matchups or doubles, and his arrow game is just beyond ridiculous with traditional Pit. All of this combined earns Earth, for sure, without a doubt, the title of best Pit and Dark Pit player in the world in Smash 4. And that's gonna wrap it up for the second part. As you can tell, it's really difficult to rank these people because it really comes down to how you rank them. So for example, the most difficult characters that I had to go over in this ranking were Zelda and Ganondorf. Zelda had the competition between Naro and Ven. So yeah, Ven may be worse than Naro because Naro is one of the best players in the world. But then again, he doesn't main Zelda. So who do we give the best Zelda title to? To the actual Zelda player that goes through all the bad matchups and goes through all the struggles with Zelda and plays is the best with her and has the most amount of results with her? Or do we give it to the better player who plays, you know, not as much Zelda but is also really good with her? Like, it's really difficult to draw the line there. Like, how can you draw the line there to effectively make a ranking out of this? It's just a question that I'm giving you guys, the audience, to kind of think about so you guys can see how difficult it is to come up with rankings like this. It's not always easy and pretty as I make it look in videos, but I mean, it takes a while. It usually takes me a while, like several hours, to come up with each spot because I just think about it like forever. I think about all the options and all the different possibilities. So it's better to go off of criteria. Like, you make the video thinking about certain criteria and then you go from there, then it's kind of easier and makes more sense to go about it. But regardless, I hope that it makes sense to you guys when watching at home. And just remember not to burn me or hate me or leave a mean comment. Don't leave a mean comment, because This is just my opinion. Don't take it too far. Okay, don't take it too far. But yeah, I hope you all enjoyed it, had a good time with it, and I sincerely hope it sparks up competition between players, which is always good. I mean, this is a competitive scene, so we all want that in some way, I guess. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. You guys lately have been extremely supportive of my comment, ideas, and just everything that I do. You're all the very best, and for that, thank you. And well, I hope to see you all in the next video. Zero out.